Jon Stewart is on a summer sabbatical from The Daily Show to direct his first film, Rosewater, based on a book by an Iranian journalist who was imprisoned and tortured while reporting on Iran's 2009 presidential election. Combined with the crackdown of journalists in Cairo, it's a stark reminder that journalism can be a dangerous profession. The freedom of the press is far from guaranteed around the world. Earlier, I spoke to Newseum's Gene Policinski about the reporters who've sacrificed their freedom in an attempt to tell the truth.
Only about 14% of the world's population lives in a country where the press is free, and it's about 43% partially free and 43% not free at all.
So green is free press and red is not at all
free. Not at all free, and you know, where government controls the media, where there's been intimidation, for example, in Mexico, where journalists are afraid to report, we consider that not free, even though by law they may be free to report.
You know, journalism can be a very dangerous profession.
Yeah.
Tell me the numbers of journalists who've lost their lives in the line of duty, as it were, over the last year.
On our journalism memorial, last year we were posting 80 plus names. The count is as high as 130 if you count people who were behind the scenes, who maybe were supporting those people on the field. It's become incredibly dangerous. I think the last 2 years or so, we've seen more journalists killed. It's complicated and added to by the fact that now anybody with a cell phone at that moment might be performing the act of journalism, or in some countries, citizen journalists are the only way that the news is getting out.
Yeah, that's one of the fascinating definitional changes. Something that's real concrete, though, is journalists in prison.
Yeah.
And this is a real problem around the world as well, and sometimes those journalists who are currently in jail are all but forgotten.
Yeah.
What are the countries that are the biggest offenders?
Well, right now, by sheer numbers, Turkey has more journalists in jail. After that, you have Iran, then you have Eritrea and China. So those are the four countries where more journalists are really in jail than anywhere else.
Let's talk about folks who are currently in prison, Americans. I understand there are two Americans currently in prison in Syria. Their whereabouts are unknown, but they are believed to be in prison in Syria.
There's Austin Tice and James Foley, one working for the Washington Post and the other for Global Post as freelancers. And right now, we don't know where they are. They're believed to be held by the Syrian government, but because there's the political complications of the U.S. and Syria, we don't know. There are at least 30 journalists missing in Syria right now. And again, when you talk about citizen journalists, people using everything from mobile phones to Twitter to blogs to get the news out, we don't know how many journalists are really being held by one side or the other. And then, you know, the tragic fact is so many people have died. That number in prison or being in captivity might even be higher, but they've been killed.
And dictatorships are in panic mode when it comes to the spread of information via social media.
They really are. You know, I think we forget sometimes in our country where we have these conflicts in law between journalists and the government, that in many, many places around the world, the option is really violence or doing your job.
This wall behind us, this is the images of the fallen. Tell us a little bit about who these folks are.
Well, it goes all the way back to 1837, when an editor was hanged for being an abolitionist. There are over 2,100 names on that wall right now. Last year, we added a little over 80. Some groups would go as high as 130. And again, it's a reminder that just bringing you and I the news, or bringing people who watch your program the news, in many countries is an act of courage that's out of proportion to where I think people see the profession. You know, there are debates about whether people are biased or opinionated or doing a good job or not, but in the bottom line, there are thousands of people around this world every day risking their lives to bring us the news. And unfortunately, we record some of them here for having given their lives in that service.